Hey guys, welcome back to another video. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe and like and comment, or just watch my other videos. Today I'm going to be talking about the Adinkra symbols.
I've been on my own for way too long. I misrule that I cannot run.
If any of you don't know what Adinkra symbols are, they represent popular proverbs, maxims. They record historical events and they express particular attitudes and behaviors related to the Akan people of Ghana. You will see Adinkra symbols mainly on cloths like kente and ntoma. The Akan people who are now living in both Ghana and Ivory Coast, they develop skills in weaving. Adinkra originally was produced by Giaman clans of Brong region. So over time, the Asante people developed Adinkra symbology. They incorporated their own philosophies and what they believed were important, folk tales and culture. They were also used in pottery and metalwork. So I'm not sure if you guys have seen, but I've seen a lot of like the things you put around your house, and they've got the symbols on them as well. And they're now incorporated in modern commercial design, architecture and sculptures and stuff like that. So you'll find Adinkra symbols on exported items such as furniture, sculptures, pottery, t-shirts, hats and other clothing items. I see a lot of people with the tattoos. So the most popular one is Nyame, which means God is Almighty. But I've seen a lot of people with those kind of tattoos. But it's important to know the meaning behind them. Each symbol is related to a proverb. One symbol doesn't mean a word, it means a whole like meaning. It has a whole meaning behind it. There's so many symbols that have different meanings and they're used in different contexts as well. During a military conflict at the beginning of the 19th century caused by Giaman trying to copy the neighbouring Asante's golden stool, the symbol of the Asante nation, which is, I'm sure a lot of you have seen it, is the golden stool, and it's really sacred. So Giaman king was killed and his Adinkra robe was taken as a trophy. With the robe came the knowledge of Adinkra, the special ink used in the printing process. Adinkra symbology. Adinkra symbols record historical events and express particular attitudes or behaviors related to or depicted figures or concepts uniquely related to abstract shapes. They represent concepts or aphorisms and are used extensively in fabrics, logo, pottery, and appear on traditional Akan gold weights. We have akoma, which means the heart, and the meaning behind that symbol is patience and tolerance. Adinkra hine, which means chief of Adinkra symbols, greatness, charisma and leadership. Then chem, which I believe means crocodile, and that is a symbol of adaptability. Nyamimu namangu, God never dies, therefore I cannot die, meaning life after death.
Sankofa,
which means return and get it. That's what the proverb is. The meaning from that is learn from the past, or West African proverb. The thing is, when we say the proverb, we don't really understand it, but it needs to be put into context. So akoma ntoso, which means linked hearts, understanding, agreement. Duafe, wooden comb, beauty, hygiene, feminine qualities. Sasi yeduro, the earth has weight, divinity of Mother Earth. And Kofena, sword of war, courage, and Dunvalor, that's one.
Ketepa,
good bed, which also means good marriage. They apply to life and they can help you problem solve, I guess, which is a good thing. The symbols are basically a expression of West African wisdom. Being Kabi, no one should bite the other, which also means peace and harmony. Akokanai, the leg of a hen, mercy or nurturing. They're literally so relatable as well. I haven't been to Ghana many times, and I've been in ceremonies, whether they be funerals, weddings. The oldest, you know, giving words of wisdom such as these, like I recognize some of these from, you know, people saying them to me. My granddad, who lives in Ghana, he was telling us so much things filled with wisdom that we could literally use in our lives, and it's amazing to think that we could, you know, like, it's such amazing advice. And the thing is, with these proverbs, you won't understand them at first, but when you get it, it literally cracks your brain. When you understand and you really apply it to your life, it's amazing advice. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, give it a like and a comment. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you like what you saw. If you have any suggestions for any videos I should do in the future, please let me know by commenting. Yeah, see you in the next one next Tuesday. Bye.